what God told me about Nnamdi Kanu and Biafran actualization, Bishop Chinemi revealed. Senior pastor of the Redemption Life Fellowship, Abia State, Bishop Jude Chinemi has opened up on a revelation he received from God 26 years ago concerning Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra IPOB. Bishop Chinemi said God told him that Nnamdi Kanu was born to achieve the sovereign state of Biafra. The cleric said that God showed him this about 26 years ago, before Ralph Owazoruke formed the movement for the actualization of the sovereign state of Biafra, MASOB. That was an Igbo man from Umuahia, Abia State's capital, that would lead the old eastern region out of Nigeria. People like us don't talk anyhow. We talk when it's necessary. The Biafran agitation, something the Lord revealed to me many years ago, 26 if not 27 years ago, that was on 4th September 1994, he said. The day I was in the Riven Hotel by Okigwe Road, Aba, in my wedding ceremony, the chairman of the wedding was Dr. Edmund Ezirim, the owner of Blessing Clinic, 97 or 95 Port Harcourt Road, Aba. It was there that the Lord revealed to me the crowd heading to Umuahia when I asked, what kind of crowd is this? Then the Lord told me that was Biafran restoration. I saw the Biafran flag, and God vividly, openly, and told me that the man that would bring Biafran would come from Umuahia. That was on the 4th of September 1994. The Lord told me Biafran would not come through Owazoruke. So later, Nnamdi Kanu now came up with Biafran agitation, and the Lord told me that Biafran will come through him. According to him, the activities of Nnamdi Kanu and his group was exactly what God revealed to him, or on the 4th of September 1994. That day was on Sunday, and it rained heavily that day, he said. Chinemi said for this reason, he never joined in any prayer for the actualization of Biafran because he knows that God had already revealed to him and the words of the Lord must surely come to pass whether people pray or not. This is what Nnamdi Kanu was born for. God sent him into this planet Earth for that purpose. So whether by prayer or not by prayer, it must surely come to pass, he added. Nnamdi Kanu is currently cooling off in detention at the Department of State Services DSS headquarters, Abuja, after he was arrested in Kenya, East Africa, and bundled to Nigeria a few weeks ago. The IPOP leader who escaped from Nigeria in 2017 and settled in the United Kingdom after security agencies invaded his Afaroku home in Umuahia, was rearrested by Kenya authorities. Although the Nigerian government has up till now not revealed how and where the IPOP leader was intercepted and brought back to Nigeria, reports suggest that he was arrested with the help of Kenya authorities, who detained him before handing him over to Nigerian authorities. He has also been arraigned before the Justice Binta Nyako of the Federal High Court, which ordered that the separatist leader be remanded at the DSS till July 26, 2021, when he was reappeared in court. Meanwhile, the IPOP leader had narrated to his lawyer how he was beaten mercilessly, tortured, and left unconscious by Kenyan authorities before being handed over to the Nigerian government. You don't need anyone to tell you that Nnamdi Kanu is appointed by God to help in the actualization of Biafra. You can see it. Everybody can see it. It is not only this man of God that has given this testimony. 80% men of God, even some of them are even clerics. Islamic cleric. Yes, some of them are Islamic cleric, Muslims. There was a man that spoke 3 days ago. He also said it. Though he is not a Nigerian, but he loved Nnamdi Kanu. He loved him, and he believed that he is God very sent to the people, to the Igbos. And then Balarabe Musa in Nottingham also said it again too. He said that how they wish that they have a person like Nnamdi Kanu. You hear that? That how he said how we wish we have a person like Nnamdi Kanu. The Igbos doesn't know who they are, doesn't know what they have. That is what he said. You can see that. In fact, we are just making a mess of opportunities. We're making a mess of opportunity. There are people that are looking for these things. They didn't get it, but we that have it, we are making a mess of it. Abi? Okay? Oh, hala. All right, my dear viewers in the house, let me hear from you anyway to know what you have to say. If you're new, don't forget to leave your comments below the comment box. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.